Hello everyone, in this video, I'm gonna show you step by step how to use Keyword Scout inside of Jungle Scout to see what shoppers are really searching for on Amazon. This tool allows you to instantly discover high converting keywords for your listing and advertising campaigns. You can even use it to get critical insights into your top competitors' keyword strategies. I'll now be taking you through three ways to use this tool. So let's get started. Number one, keyword research. To begin, select your marketplace. Next, you can enter in either a keyword or an ASIN. I'm gonna start with the keyword swim mask. Hit search. You now see all the keywords that people used to ultimately purchase this style of product. So this is great because while you may think the word swim mask is the best keyword, you'll be able to see what other keywords might be even more relevant. So, for example, snorkel mask here has a much higher search volume, so that might be a good one to target. Now up here, you see how many total keywords are currently in this list. If you check this, you can select all the keywords to save them to a keyword list. Now it can be a good idea to go through this list first and deselect any keywords that aren't relevant for your product. Now, click here to add them to either a new keyword list or an already existing one. So I'm gonna create a new one. This list is now saved under keyword lists, and you can come back to it when you're building your listing or setting up your PPC campaigns. You also have the option of downloading this list by clicking over here. Number two. Competitor research. So, entering in a keyword, that's a really great first step to doing your keyword research. Now, another great way to improve your keyword list is by searching for what keywords your competitors are ranking for. In order to do that, let's head over to Amazon and grab either the URL or ASIN of up to 10 of your top competitors. Now, paste them in here and click search. Here, you see how many keywords these products are collectively ranking for. Again, you can click this checkbox to select all the keywords and then add them to a list, or you can go through the results and select specific keywords to save. Okay, so let's look at our first keyword. If you click this icon, you'll be taken to Amazon to perform that search. Clicking here will open up a graph of that ASIN's historical search volume. Now let's look at all the data points that we have for this keyword. So here you see the exact search volume for this keyword over the past 30 days. We can also see the 30-day broad match search volume, which includes keywords before, in between, and after, as well as stemmings, plurals, and all that sort of thing. We've also got a 30 and 90 day trend. This shows the change in search volume of this keyword. Next, you can see the dominant category for this keyword. Recommended promotions means that this is how many sales we anticipate that you would need per day in order to rank on the first page of results for this keyword. Next, we've got PPC exact and broad match bids. Again, this is how much we believe that you would need to bid in order for your ad to display on the first page of search results. Ease to rank tells you how easy it is for a new product to rank for this keyword. The relevancy score tells you how relevant this keyword is to the one in your original search. This column will only show data here if you entered a keyword up at the top, as opposed to ASINs like we currently have in our example. Organic product count tells you the total number of products returned for this particular keyword. Sponsored product count tells you the total number of sponsored products recently detected for that keyword. Organic rank, this is the organic rank of the highlighted ASIN. Sponsored rank, this is the sponsored rank of the highlighted ASIN. Finally, number three, using filters. Sometimes you may want to narrow down your keyword list, and you can do so based on specific criteria. So let's come up to our filters over here. Here are your options for filtering. Exact match, 30 days. Set a minimum or maximum for the number of Amazon searches for that exact keyword over the past month. Use this, for example, to find either only keywords with a high search volume or perhaps find those that have a mid-range search volume, as these would be easier to rank for. Broad match, 30 days. Here, you set a minimum or maximum for the number of Amazon searches for that keyword, including words before, in between, and after, as well as plurals and stemmings. Word count, set limits for the number of words in that keyword phrase. You could use this, for example, to find only long-tail keywords. Organic product count, set limits for the total number of products that display for this keyword. Sponsored product count, set limits for the total number of products recently detected for that keyword. There are also some advanced filters. Organic rank, set limits for where the highlighted ASIN ranks organically for that keyword. Sponsored rank, set limits for the sponsored position of the highlighted ASIN. One way you could use these rank filters is to find keywords that you rank well for both organically and as sponsored. These are keywords that you may want to stop spending on as you're already getting good visibility organically. At any point, if you've entered in limits for a filter, you can click clear in order to reset. If at any point you're unsure of what a specific filter does, you can always hover over this little question mark for a short summary. If you create a filter set that you like, you can come up here and save it to use in the future. You can also load any filter sets that you've previously created. Next to that, you can choose which columns of results you want to see. Because of how many data sets are available to you, we recommend going here and selecting only the ones that you're currently interested in. You're able to sort your results by any of these columns, ascending or descending. Over here, you see how many pages of results you have. And those are the basics of using Keyword Scout for your keyword research. I hope this tutorial has helped you get started using it so that you can pinpoint the keywords that have the greatest impact. Now go ahead and try this out for yourself by clicking the link down in the description to sign up for Jungle Scout. Did you know that Jungle Scout offers way more tools than just Keyword Scout? And that all the tutorials are located right here in this playlist? Make sure you check out the next video on how to use our Jungle Scout tools.